It's that time of the week again, Free for Friday, also known as the Friday Threesome. Three films, all with a common theme or link, reviewed and ranked in under 20 minutes. And this week, it's Mondo Macabro, weird films from around the world. Mondo Macabro started life as a book, first published in 1998 by St. Martin's Press in the USA. It covered weird B-movie horror, exploitation, and fantasy films. It was developed into a TV series by Pete Toombs and Andy Stark, and shown on Channel 4 after midnight in their 4 later slot. One of the few times being a teenage insomniac paid off. But to be fair, there was some funny stuff shown on BBC Learning Zone. It was at a time when Channel 4 showed things other than twee property programmes and dehumanising trash. I bought the book shortly after by importing it from the Amazon USA site, and my film wishlist became greatly expanded. After this, a DVD label was set up, publishing some of the films featured. It was short-lived in the UK, but still lives on in the USA as a DVD and Blu-ray label. And we're covering a few films from that label today, so let's get into this. The first film was a pain in the neck to review because it's an Argentinian vampire film. Yeah, I'm sure you've lost a rib over that one-liner. It's Sangre de Virgin by Emilio Vieira. Excuse the pronunciations. It was rated 18 for the UK Mondo Macabro DVD. It came out in 1967 and it was around 10 years ahead of its time. It predates a lot of gory bloody slasher films. I know some slasher films were out in the 60s, but they weren't anywhere near as gory as the ones in the late 70s and early 80s. And also a lot of soft-focus exploitation films, like Emmanuel. It was originally banned by the Argentinian government because they didn't want sleazy films that showed its country in a bad light. It resurfaced in 1974 before getting banned again in 1980. It was producer Arrestes Truco's idea to make a vampire film. I remember that when I told my wife about it, she said I was completely nuts. The film is set in the 1800s and a wealthy heiress is forbidden from marrying the man she loves and instead marries this guy. The man she loves goes on a killing spree. He's a vampire. Then it flashes forward to present times, which are the 1960s. A party takes place at the castle, and after the party cum orgy, a spate of strange murders start happening. This is a fun film. It's obviously low budget. You can tell because rather than use bats, he uses a red filter on seagulls. Because you have to have some form of bats, don't you? But you can tell a lot of enthusiasm and love went into the film. It's not a great film, but it has a crude charm. Mahakaal. I really don't know how to say the name. It's by Tusi and Sean Ramsey, also known as the Ramsey Brothers. They hit pay dirt in the mid-1980s, despite making horror since the 1970s. The film we are reviewing today is a Bollywood take on Nightmare on Elm Street. The plot is very similar to the Freddy movies, with Anita seeing Freddy in her dreams. Afterwards, she wakes up with scratches all over her body and also has visions of her classmates being murdered. We have a Bollywood take on the different murders featured in the American films. As well as the horror, we also have a lot of comic relief from this character called Canteen, who does a Michael Jackson impersonation, and the soundtrack even rips off Thriller. With it being a Bollywood film, there are a few musical scenes, and while they're not horrible, they go on way too long. There's also scenes of sexual assault, broken up by a crazy and very corny kung fu fight. At the time, Bruce Lee, Van Damme, and the Ninja Cannon films, as well as Jackie Chan films, were all doing the rounds on VHS. So why can't Bollywood have a go? And these scenes are very badly done indeed. Punches don't land, cardboard sets break. They're just not convincing, but they are very funny. The film has bags of atmosphere, drawing influence from Gothic Hammer horror of the 1970s. And if you were 12, you might find this film scary, but everyone else will have a hoot. Ooh la la, sacre bleu, and other French stereotypes. It's Casa d'Apartamento, or the French Sex Murders. It was directed by Ferdinando Merighi as F.L. Morris. Despite the name, it's actually an Italian film and an underrated giallo. It's B-movie, and not only camp in its style, everyone involved knew what they were dealing with, which is a low-budget and silly send-up of giallo films. Marta Lanza visits his favourite Parisian brothel and starts slapping around a prostitute played by Barbara Boucher. This scene, believe it or not, is played for laughs, with cartoon-style sound effects and over-exaggerated acting. I know domestic violence and abuse is no joke, but here, it's tongue-in-cheek. Marta Lanza goes on the run, and after his death you have a strange whodunit. Everyone is a suspect. From bad bitch brothel owner Madame Colette, played by Swedish actress Anita Ekberg, Marianne, Rosalba Neri, her lover Pepe, Rolf Eden, or creepy mad scientist Waldemar, who has an inappropriate relationship with his daughter. Robert Sacchi is on the case as Inspector Fontaine. The plot is as jumbled as most Shelley's, and reminded me a lot of Inferior Yellow in The Folds of the Flesh, which Marighi worked on as assistant director. This film has been much maligned over the years in favour of much slicker giallo films, such as those by Bava and Dario Argento. Fans of sleazy giallo and Italian crime will have a lot of fun with this one, spotting cameos by regular faces and the OTT gore effects, and the absurd plot makes for a fun night in. This week we're rating and ranking them yet again, and for me every single film on the list is a 6 out of 10. I've enjoyed watching them, but I've not loved watching them, if you know what I mean. Every single film sort of middle ranking for me, but we have to have a best and a worst in the middle. And worst for me is Mahakaal the Monster. Musical scenes boring, songs pretty good, but they go on way too long. The sex comedy really jarring now. Once again, it would have been fun in 1993, but we're in 2023, we've seen it all before, and now it just looks a bit rapey, to be honest, you know. But this one has aged pretty badly, and it looked dated even in 1993, let's be honest. But the actual horror scenes are pretty good. The makeup effects are rubbish, especially the Freddy makeup. Absolute rubbish. It just looks like he had clay smeared on his face and they put a few dents in it with a lollipop stick. It's not a particularly bloody film, but it was rated 18 by the BBFC for cinema, and it hasn't had a subsequent release in the UK. I think it could be reclassified as 15 today. The dream sequences are actually quite well done. Best scene is where the Freddy gloves come through the wall, an obvious homage to Night of the Living Dead, and a pretty cool scene. Definitely best scene in the film. It's sort of a weird film, but I do recommend you check it out. View it as a party film, not a horror film. Get your mates round, a few beers for your orange juices, but be warned, it does go on an hour too long. And it did go on an hour too long. That's why it's the worst film. That's the only reason. Middle ranking has to go to Blood of the Virgins. Really fun film. Came out in 67 in Argentina, but it's probably about 10 years ahead of its time. Predates a lot of the sexy films coming out, like the sexploitation films of the 1970s and the sex comedies, and also the erotic films which followed, like Emmanuel and stuff like that. Actually a really violent film. Predates a lot of the really bloody Hammer Dracula films, like the Christopher Lee ones and the Countess Dracula, Vampire Circus and stuff like that. I'd say it's not as good as most of those films, but it's maybe a more interesting film. Really fun film, obviously low budget, made up from different prints, I think. It looks a bit disjointed and a bit weird, but definitely ahead of its time. As a scene where people take drugs at a party, but it doesn't pass judgment, which is rare for the 60s. It would have even been rare in the 70s, because a lot of drug exploitation came out around that time. A fun film, but it's not a great film. And top film, French Sex Murders. Loads of really fun cameos. Two best performances for me were the bad bitch herself, Madame Colette, played by Anita Ekberg. I think I've got his name right, I may have got it wrong. Voldemort, Mad Professor, Howard Vernon. Been in I don't know how many Jess Franco films, most of them though, most of the well-known ones anyway. He's great in it, really sends it up. Really campy acting by him, you know, but really good fun. It's not taking itself too seriously, and it's all the better for it. Like, the heads look like they came from mannequins out of a shop window. Really rubbishy, cheesy effects, but that's why it's so fun. I actually had a blast watching this. I don't think it's a great film, and Mondo Macabro release is out of print, so best thing to do is to buy the Vinegar Syndrome Blu-ray, which has English dub and also Italian original audio and a really great commentary track. I'd say I'm probably preaching to the perverted on this one. If you're watching this video, you're probably familiar with this sort of stuff already, and they're all worth checking out if you're a fan of your exploitation. If you like into something a bit more mainstream, and you're not into like what I call the red meat films, they're not going to be for you.